Hi, my name is Gary Gibb, and I work in the product management area here at Domo, and I'm excited to talk to you about the Domo APIs and how you can use those to better manage your Domo instance. The way you get to this area is by going to developers.domo.com, and when you get inside the site, you go to Resources and come down to the Data API section. Once inside here, what I want to walk through with you today is the Getting Started and some of the other areas of the site that are available. Under Getting Started, it goes through a simple example on what you can use using curl. Curl is an easy way using a command line interface where you can talk to the APIs and just get a better understanding of how they work and what kind of responses you can get. The first part of connecting to Domo APIs is getting an authorization token, an Oauth 2.0 token, so that you can then talk to the other APIs. The way you get an Oauth token is with two pieces of information. You have to have a client ID and a client secret. The way you get the client ID and client secret is by going under My Accounts and creating a new client. When you click on New Client, you can name it and call it My Application and give it a description. And then you specify what kind of access this application will need. In this case, we're going to create one that has data and user access. Now I create that client, and what will come back is a client ID and a client secret. These two pieces of information will allow you to get an Oauth token and access all of the APIs inside of the site. Now I'm going to return to the data section and continue with the Getting Started section. So once I have access to these two pieces of information, a client ID and a client secret, I can use curl commands to better understand the APIs. In this case, we're going to go in so we can get an access token. You pass in your client ID and your client secret, and here's the sample response that comes back from that call. After you have the response to this, we'll give you this access token here. This is the information that you will need to add to every one of your API calls so that they are authenticated. Once you have that piece of information, you can do additional calls. In this example, I'm going to list all the users that exist inside of my Domo instance. So I use a curl command. I pass it in the user's access. And then in here where it says your valid Oauth access token is where you'll paste the information that you just retrieved in this call. This is the same process that you use for all API access. After you make that call, you'll get a response somewhat of this kind of form where it will give you a listing of all of the users that are available inside of your Domo instance. Now to go back, here's the more detailed sections. In the authentication section, you can get more details about what authorization clients do, how the API works, and some examples. Under the data section, you can go in and see the APIs that are available. There's the ability to create new data sets, read data sets, list all the available data sets, update a specific data set, delete the data set that you have identified, push new data to it, and pull data out of it. In the user section, you have similar APIs where you can come in, create new users, get existing user, list all users that are in a particular instance, update the user, or delete a user. That's the introduction to Domo APIs.